Hi, this is Russ Andersson. In this tutorial, I'm going to show how you can hand animate approximate tracking data when a feature is occluded. This is especially good for object tracking, where there might be just a small number of trackable features, and you want them to be valid as much of the time as possible. This method is better suited for crane and dolly shots, where the motion is nice and smooth. If you've got a handheld shot, there can be a lot of vibration, and you'd be better off using offset tracking. Method also isn't that helpful if you've got a whole lot of trackers, then it's really not worth the time to bother with this. Instead, you just rely on the averaging of all the trackers that you do have. In this example, we're going to be using this pretty simple example shot, and it does have a bunch of occlusion issues that we're going to deal with. So let's get started. I'm going to hold down the C key to get a temporary tracker creation mode. And I'll go over here into the mini tracker view and use the middle mouse button to scroll forward into the shot. So sooner or later, here comes our pole. I'm just going to illustrate first what the standard approach for this is, which is just to turn off the tracker enable. Now roll forward until the obstruction is gone. Now you can just wiggle in the mini tracker view and the tracker is re-enabled and you can reposition it to the right spot. So at this point, let me just make some adjustments here in the graph editor. We'll turn off these velocities in the figure of merit. We'll turn on the position tracks, hand animated track, and the enable track. I'll turn off the background just to make it a little easier to see. So here you can see the enable is turned off. While the enable is off, there's no tracker data at all. You're basically saying, we don't know what happened in here. So this can be good much of the time. If you had a object track and this was a crucial tracker, not such a good thing. So let's just keep on running forward, and soon enough, here comes our next pole. So let's do this one differently now. And I'm actually going to do this when the pole is still pretty far away from the tracker, just for illustration. And I'm going to turn on the by hand button. It says that I want to hand animate. And you'll see that there is a little jump already, because basically now we're no longer doing any tracking, even on this current frame. So if you watch in the camera view here, you'll see that with that by hand on, that tracker isn't doing anything at all. And we'll just wait until the object, that pole, is well clear. And now we'll just go and drag it back into place. And as I do that, you'll see now we've gotten this nice linear interpolation between the position where we turned it off and where we are now. So if I go and adjust this position, you know, you can see that the whole entire path is following along. So what I do now, turn off the by hand, and now I can keep on tracking off into the shot. Now, not only can we do the linear interpolation there, this is why I left a bit of room here, I can go into the interior where the by hand is active and start creating additional keys. So I'll put one there, then maybe I'll drag over here. And as I do this, you know, you see the entire path is changing around and we're getting this smooth spline interpolation in the interior portion where the by hand is active. So you have complete control over that. You can even go in the graph editor and drag things around however you like. This is giving you whatever kind of control you need to best produce a trajectory that represents what you think happened during that collection of frames. So it's ultimately an artistic decision. You get to make that trajectory up based on, you know, what the rest of the image is doing, how smoothly you think the thing is moving, whether you think it's accelerating, whatever. You can make your choices and get something to happen. So now we'll just keep on tracking forward into the shot. And now, you know, we can do the same thing again. And on we go. So you see, we get, you know, the by hand track is animated, so you can create any number of different regions. You can go back and add keys to these intermediate spots at any point in time. Those are fully editable and so on. And, you know, each of these regions is being treated separately. Now let's go do and get into a little bit more of a fine point and fun point. Now, here, suppose we'd done the tracking initially here, as we did, and we used the enable animation when this first pole went by. Now, suppose that we decided, you know, hey, we really need to have some animated data in there. It turned out to be a key tracker there. So all we need to do, go over to the frame where that and where the enable turned off. Now we're just going to turn on the by hand. And there's a little bit of logic in the program that goes and says, ah, you know, what we're doing is converting this enable animation into a by hand animation. So it's fixed up the enable track, it's fixed up the by hand track to match. And now we've got that intermediate trajectory between the beginning and ending point. And again, we can go and start editing it up however we like. So that's pretty nifty. Another thing, suppose we're out here, we're tracking away. Maybe we add a couple keys out here as we move through the shot. And now we decide, you know, hey, the tracking really isn't good in some area. You know, here this is definitely a very boring sort of shot for this. You know, maybe there's some bouncing around here that we don't like the looks of for whatever reason. Maybe there was some vibration on whatever it is that we're tracking. And we want to go and hand animate that instead. So we can come back and do that. Now, I'll do it. And notice that there's a key point to this, that according to the rules of the by hand, the, you know, its function is to take all the keys within that by hand region and spline interpolate them. When you first turn on this by hand in this kind of a situation, basically you're including the entire rest of the shot. If this was somewhere out in the middle, you could be taking out all the rest of the tracking in the shot, potentially. And that would be a bad idea. So instead, what the by hand is doing is it just goes, in this kind of situation where it extends to the end, it just stops at the next key. You can see if I go and move this around here, you'll see that only this small initial portion of the path is affected rather than the entire thing. That's a good thing. It prevents you from having to go back and, you know, rerun through those other frames, which, you know, would be straightforward enough to do, but it would just take some time, especially if there were a couple hundred of them or whatever. This turns out to be a nice little practical thing, and it turns out often to be, you know, what you want to do anyway, because, you know, typically now you have maybe some other keys that are back on track here, and you only want to take out this one little range of frames. So this lets you do that, and then typically you'd go out to that key and drop the by hand back off again. So in this, you notice that we're talking about by end all the way, you know, off to the right here, increasing frame numbers. I'll point out that this entire setup works with both backwards and forwards tracking, so that, you know, if you've got backwards trackers, kind of everything is running in reverse and all the logic is reversed. So we've got that nailed down. Just to recap one important point, though, remember that there is a difference between using the enable animation that we did initially here, where there was no tracker data in the middle. When you use the enable and turn it off, disable a tracker, you're saying, I don't know what happened in the middle. And that won't affect the solve directly. When you're using the by hand, you're saying, I know what happened in the middle. I know what happened on all of those frames. And if you haven't done a good job at picking that out and deciding what to have there, you can actually make that solution worse. If you've got a whole lot of trackers, it makes more sense to enable and disable. The hand animation makes sense when there's a comparatively small number of trackable features and every last one of them counts. Again, often that's for object tracking. So hopefully this gives you an idea how to use this technique. Thanks for watching.